Hello there. A very good morning to you. Ben Turney is back with us today, as promised, from Kavango Resources, because you've identified a cluster of three electromagnetic conductors. We're going to talk about this in much further detail, why this is potentially a big step for the firm. So why do we care? Why is this a big deal, Ben? Tell us.
So in the KSZ, we're looking for these large scale conductor bodies that could potentially be nickel copper sulfide ore bodies. If you think about what a metal ore body is, they're quite tightly, densely packed accumulations of metal deposits, which obviously by their very nature are quite conductive. They conduct electricity much better than surrounding country rocks. So we're using this TDEM technology, time domain electromagnetic technology, to look for these high speed conductor targets. Now, we've known about the B1 target since last July. That was when we first identified this and released that information to public domain. We drilled that target, we attempted to drill that target back in February. Unfortunately, the original model that we had was a bit more complicated than we originally modeled. The actual geology itself was much more complex, and there were two conductive bodies that were actually present subsurface, which we'd modeled as a single one. So the first drill hole that we drilled in the search of this target didn't hit. However, the electromagnetic downhole survey that we ran, that showed us both the main primary EM target that we were looking for, the B1 conductor, as well as this other conductive body, which we now believe is a fault. Now, that could be potentially significant. I'll explain why in a moment. But overall, we're looking for these individual targets, and our original Norilsk-style model is very much based. If you look at the Norilsk deposits, they actually occur in clusters. So you have these huge nickel copper sulfide bodies that have been in production for best part of 100 years, and you have them in accumulations, in groups together. And what today's news shows is that for the first time, we've actually identified a group of these cluster targets, pretty much exactly as our idealized model predicted. So it's very, very good news, and we're very excited about it.
Do you want to maybe elaborate there on when you were talking about it being potentially significant?
Yeah, sure. So obviously we need to go and drill these targets to see what is actually down there. But to have found these three EM conductors in quite close proximity to one another, also in proximity and aligned with a possible geological fault, that's the other body that we think we've identified subsurface. If you think about the way that the geology of these systems works, then the Earth's crust, you have this tectonic activity, which causes these faults to open up and vast amounts of magma comes up to surface. But obviously, broadly speaking, faults are fairly linear. They're sort of fairly straight in terms of their orientation and shape. So we think it's quite significant that these two new targets that we found appeared to be aligned with this, what we believe is the subsurface geology. So it's still all circumstantial at this stage. We need to go and drill these targets, but we definitely do have to go and drill these targets. I mean, they're such high quality at this stage, we don't really have any choice but to go and drill these. But sort of from a circumstantial point of view, all the evidence appears to be pointing in the same direction, that these bodies are connected to one another. They seem to be in the right geological setting. They're at the right level as well. So from the holes that we have drilled, with what we understand about the stratigraphy, so in other words, the rock layers, they appear to be aligned with the Karoo Age gabbros, which again was our original exploration target. And so far, everything seems to be pointing in the right direction. So this is a very, very exciting step forward for Kavango.
All right. So the first signs of evidence of what you were looking for, if you like.
Well, the first signs, I think, were last summer. It's really sort of building on that initial sign that we had. We've now got multiple signs all pointing in the same direction. I think had we known what we know now back last summer, it would have changed our drill strategy, certainly for the last campaign. But that was also part of the point of a proof of concept campaign. I mean, the geological models are great, but until you've actually drill tested them and you've got the drill cores to support the models and help constrain those, it is essentially educated guesswork. So we're going to be publishing the results of the drill campaign in the very near future. I've managed to find a nickel expert who's just completed a site visit down to our projects in Botswana. He finished last Friday, so he's now in the process of preparing a report for us. So again, we're going to have more to report on this to show how this all ties together and really sort of showing why we are all as excited as we are.
All right, we're looking forward to hearing more. Thank you very much indeed on your exploration journey there at Kavango Resources with Ben Turney.
Thank you.